What is an impermanent loss? Instead of definitions, let's see it straight as an example. Impermanent loss occurs to those who provide liquidity into liquidity pools. Imagine there's a pool with ADA and WMT. Most of the liquidity pools require the assets to be in a 50-50 ratio of value. This means that if the value of one ADA is 50 cents and the value of WMT is one quarter, there has to be double the amount of WMT than ADA in the pool, so the dollar value of all ADA equals the dollar value of all WMT in the pool. Now imagine you, as a liquidity provider, deposit ADA and WMT into the pool to gain from the trading fees and ADA staking rewards. The liquidity you deposit must be also in a 50-50 ratio. So let's say you deposit 20 ADA and 40 WMT. The value of deposited ADA is $10. The value of WMT is also $10. So you provided liquidity worth $20. Let's work with really small numbers for a better demonstration and imagine the pool now contains 200 ADA and 400 WMT in total, deposited by all the liquidity providers. So the value of the pool is $200, and $20 of it is yours. That means you're entitled to 10% share of the pool. Once you want to withdraw your share, it may not be the same value in dollars as it was when you deposited it. That's because of the volatility of the value of the assets in the pool. A liquidity pool determines the price of its assets from the assets ratio in the pool. Most liquidity pools use the automated market maker model to know the current prices of the assets in the pool. Automated market maker requires the product of the assets to remain constant by this simple formula. This way, the fewer ADA remains in the pool, the more WMT it costs to buy. Even if it gets down to very little, the price of it goes up exponentially. Therefore, the pool basically never runs out of it. Now, imagine that the price of ADA rises from 50 cents to $1. This is the point where arbitragers, usually bots, come in to buy out the ADA from this pool for the original 50 cents and sell it to a different pool or exchange for $1 for their profit. They keep buying more and more, and the automated market maker will keep charging them more and more until the value of ADA in the pool reaches $1 and it's not profitable to buy and sell it anymore. As you can see, they can buy almost 59 ADA for the price lower than $1. Once there is only around 141 ADA, its price is $1, and it's not profitable to buy it and sell elsewhere anymore. So, because of the ADA value change and the traders, there's now rounded up to 141 ADA and 566 WMT in the pool. Their multiply product is still 80,000. The value of the pool is currently rounded up to $283. Remember, when you deposited into this pool, its total value was $200. But because of the ADA value change, the pool's value has risen to $283. If you now withdrew your 10% share of it, you would get $28. That's $8 more than you deposited. That sounds nice, but here's the catch called the impermanent loss. If you haven't deposited those 20 ADA and 40 WMT into the pool and just kept them in your wallet, thanks to the price rise of ADA, your 20 ADA in the wallet would now have $20 value, plus your 40 WMT would still have the value of $10. In total, you would now hold the value of $30 in your wallet. But since you deposited them in the pool and withdrew them, you hold $28. The $2 difference in this case is the impermanent loss. So, it's the difference between holding assets in a liquidity pool and holding them in your wallet. It's called impermanent because it's just on paper. It's the amount you would have less if you withdrew your assets from the liquidity pool. In that case, it would become real and permanent. You can still keep the ADA and WMT in the pool and wait for the value of ADA to come back to what it was when you deposited it, and then the impermanent loss will come back to zero. The greater the volatility of the assets in the pool, the greater impermanent loss you're potentially exposed to. You may ask, why then provide liquidity into a pool and risk the impermanent loss? In the first place, When you provide liquidity, you get a portion of the trading fees from the pool. The share from fees can not just offset the impermanent loss, but create profit. Secondly, by providing liquidity into a pool containing ADA, you can receive ADA staking rewards. Moreover, you can reinvest the rewards for further gains in farming. If you choose a double yield farm, you can gain even more. Lastly, on WingRiders, you can reinvest your rewards even further by depositing them into Boosting Vault to raise your farming rewards. This way, you can consider impermanent loss just as a necessary loss one must experience in order to enjoy all these benefits of providing liquidity on WingRiders.